Big swings in weather this time of year. And Jason, you had said that Tuesday was very, very warm. And tomorrow morning is going to be very different.
Oh, yeah. I mean, it was about 6 days ago. We were close to 90 degrees. Yeah. Tuesday, we were upwards towards 80. And now tomorrow morning, we could have wind chills in the mid-20s for some of us. So the swings of spring are crazy. And, I mean, this is Iowa, isn't it? These are the weeks that, well, Iowa makes possible for us in the spring. Frost advisory. You can see it there in that light blue color. Overnight lows nearing 33 degrees, and off to the northwest, we could be seeing overnight lows of 30 degrees or even less in locations. That freeze warning goes from 1 a.m. on Friday to 8 a.m. So the cold is back upon us. You look outside right now, though, things are looking pretty good. We've got, of course, dark skies, but quiet skies for us, and that temperature has dropped a little bit. We're down to 49. That breeze making it feel more like 44 out there. 43 up in Spencer, Mason City at 41. And we have got upper 40s to mid 40s through central and southern portions of the state. So we had a little bit of cloud cover earlier, cleared out. Now we got another patch of clouds. It's building its way on in. Not a lot, but you can see that line right there. So that's kept some of our temperatures up a little bit higher. But when you wake up tomorrow morning and you step outside, it is going to feel like a completely different day. That is for sure. We're seeing temperatures dip down into the low to mid 30s. We will have sunshine and the breeze in the morning won't be that bad, but it is going to get cooking in the afternoon with sustained winds upwards of 20 miles per hour. And we'll likely see gusts over 30 miles per hour. Temperature wise, though, pushing back into the upper 50s to low 60s. So though we start cold, the day's not going to be bad. Should be pretty comfortable besides that pesky breeze out there. Tracking things out for you. You can see that breeze light to start and then widespread gusts, 30 to 35 miles per hour. Wouldn't doubt that we see some gusts of around 40 miles per hour. But again, we've got the sun and a little bit of cloud cover to the north and south in the afternoon. That takes a hike into the overnight, which isn't necessarily a good thing because we will again be talking about cold air to start your Saturday in breezy conditions. Wind chills, which we'll go over here in a second, could be in the 20s for a lot of us. So winds continue to be blustery as we head into the end of your weekend, but checking out Friday morning, mid 20s for wind chills to the north. Most of us hovering in the upper 20s to low 30s. Saturday morning, it gets a little colder yet, pushing teens for wind chills through northern portions of the state. 25 for Grinnell, 26 for the metro. Kind of crazy that we saw tornadoes just a couple days ago, and now we're talking near winter conditions for us. Wind chills in the 20s again Sunday morning, but we will eventually get a little bit of a relaxation of this cold. It's going to take us a little bit, though. 35 is your overnight low tonight. Again, plan on a breeze tomorrow, back up to 59 degrees, so below average. We don't have many of those below average days anymore, so we've got sunshine to go along with that. And again, breezy conditions as that west northwest breeze takes hold and again really, really starts to churn out those winds. That 8-day forecast not looking too bad. We do eventually warm back up. We're at 54 for your high on Saturday with those breezy conditions. Your overnight low is again hovering close to freezing Saturday and Sunday morning. 37 Monday morning, pushing 70 degrees, but we've got that chance for some showers that will continue on into Tuesday. So much needed rain on tap for us again, and we'll have more chances headed in the end of the week, Thursday and Friday, with highs approaching 70 by the end of the week.